As soon as one thinks about letting multiple users access a file system, it becomes clear that we will need some notion of access rights. Looking at our directory tree here again, it should be clear that Alice should not be able to see guests or Bob's file unless they say it's okay. And we certainly don't want to let just any user access the operating system's files. Ultimately, for each user file pair, we need to know what permissions that user has. That is, which of the basic actions of reading, writing, and executing the file is he allowed to do. Conceptually, we can think of this as a giant matrix, with users for the columns and files as the rows, for instance. And we could store the information that way, but it would be pretty inefficient. Think about how many files would have the exact same set of values. Unix-like operating systems achieve efficiency by assigning an owner and a group to each file. Here I'm displaying this information as the ls command would show it in the terminal. The owner, or user of the file, is typically the creator of the file, and the group might be faculty or staff or students or something like that in a university setting. We have separate read, write, and execute bits for the owner or user, the group, and then another set for everybody else. This gives us a total of 9 bits instead of 3 times the number of users on the system. Permissions on directories make the system even more complicated. The basic rule is that reading affects your ability to see what's in the directory. Writing affects your ability to create, delete, and rename files in the directory. Both of these are intuitive if you think about a directory as a file itself containing the names of the files and subdirectories in it. Execute permissions are a little more confusing, as they control whether you can pass through the directory and access its contents in ways other than just manipulating the file names. For cases where more detailed permissions are needed, access control lists are sometimes used on various operating systems. These make it possible to create arbitrary row values in our permissions matrix by granting permissions to individual users or other groups defined in the file system. I encourage you to explore some more on your own. Some good places to start are provided in the instructor notes.